Oh, be careful. Ah! Ah!
Hello, welcome to Taskmaster. I'm Greg Davies and I'm just your average guy. I like fast cars, good wine and the feel of a strong mountain wind howling through my legs as I look across my kingdom, hands on hips, naked as the day I was born, naked as my creator intended, fully naked. It's within this kingdom that five disparate souls have been doing battle. Their task completing ability so far has ranged from good to... Are you all right? Seriously, didn't mean to call someone. Let's open a new chapter. But before we do, still thinking about me naked on the mountain, aren't you? Me too. Hot sauce. Please welcome Dara Ó Briain, Fern Brady, John Kearns, Munya Chawawa, and Millican. And next to me, a man who confided in me recently that he thinks all primary school teachers are the scum of the earth.
That's little Alex Horne!
Not all. Not all.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Greg.
Hi, mate.
Oh, I'm feeling so wistful.
What's happening?
I was just sort of thinking back. I was trying to remember my first memory. I was trying to think, what's my first memory? And I think... It's weird. I think it's the first time I tasted ham. I was in a restaurant or something like that with my wife, and 2008. It was wafer thin ham. Have you had wafer thin ham?
Yep.
I think that's my first memory. So I thought I'd say that.
Okay. And the punchline?
Do you want some euros? You can have some euros. Yeah. Okay, 50 euros.
Right, let's get on with the prize task, shall we?
Today you've asked them all to bring in the most useless thing that you've bought that cost over £20.
Hmm.
And yes, the item Greg Davies thinks is the most useless will get its owner five satisfying points. Then at the end of the show, the overall winner will take home over £100 worth of prizes. Whoa, mama. Good, good.
Right, Fern.
I have built a harness and leash for my cat.
Here is Fern's cat harness. A genuine thing.
We all went, ah, but I think we were doing that at the pretend cat. Not at the fairly S&M-looking cat.
My gym membership hadn't really worked out, so I had this notion that the cat was going to do all these outdoors things with me. I think we've got video footage.
Yes, yes, this is the cat. God. The cat wearing the harness.
Time for your walk. Come on. I cannot believe I thought this was a good idea. Oh, my God!
It's pretty useless.
That was £70, by the way.
Jesus Christ. Dara.
I, it turns out, purchased a worm trumpet.
Yeah, this is Dara's worm trumpet.
There you go. You're supposed to lie in the ground and put your ear to it and you can hear the worms move in the ground below.
Wow. <Yeah.
laughs> And actually, if you do listen to it, you don't hear a lot. And even if you do, it's worms. It's not like it's opening a magical door into
They're not tap dancing. So far, so strong.
So far, so far. Yeah,
but great news.
John next.
John's here.
So it's a streaker for Sabuya.
Yes, it is, and here it is.
You bought it.
Yeah, I bought that. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I love that.
Wow.
It's useless because I don't own any Sabuya.
This is one of John's strongest things he's done on the show so far. Munya! What have you brought in?
I have brought in a golden snitch fidget spinner.
Wow.
So, I have to say, this is not actually linked to Harry Potter. It cost me 15 quid. I bought it in because it's got more emotional significance than it does use.
Incredible.
Because I had a very strict Zimbabwean Christian dad. Growing up, I wasn't allowed to watch Harry Potter. So this isn't just an object, it's an act of rebellion.
Wow. Ooh. Great story.
Yeah.
Shame it only cost 15 quid. It subsequently fails. Were you secretly into Harry Potter then?
Yeah, massively. Like, all the other guys at school were watching porn and I was watching The Chamber of Secrets.
Did you have to sneak off and watch it somewhere?
Yeah, I had to watch it under the covers. I had to make a little tent.
You had to make a Harry Potter tent.
Oh, dear me. Should we pretend it cost £21?
Yeah, give it to him. OK. But I'll ask him.
OK, hey, Munya, how much was it?
£21.
Sarah?
I've decided to try and make vegetables more fun to stop me eating so many sweets. So I bought a mandolin. The reason it's useless is because I used it once and I genuinely threw away something called a finger protector. And I shouted to my husband, look, 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 it's going well. And I had a courgette and it was going well. And then it went down too quickly and took the top of my finger off.
Let's have a look at the murderous object.
OK, here is the mandolin. Here we go.
So I took it in a bag of ice into A&E and it was perched on a slice of courgette. And the nurse held it up and went, what were you having for your tea?
I think it's quite useful if you use it properly and you don't take your digit off.
Well, I was trying to lose weight and I did manage to lose a little bit.
The woman took the end of her finger off, so let's give her more than one.
Right.
So we'll start with 2 points.
So, Sarah, you get 2 points.
Joint 3 points to Fern and Munya.
OK, they're joint third. Good.
Yes. Incredibly, I'm going to put the worm trumpet in second place. 4 to Dara, and for 5, it's just mystifying why the man would buy the streaker. 5 to John Kearns.
There we go, 5 points to John Kearns!
Do you have a task ready, Alex?
Yes, I do, and in some ways, this was a rubbish shoot for everybody. Hi, Fern.
Hiya.
Hello, Munya.
Alex, let me tell you this right now. Got a good feeling about this.
Get the most pleasure.
Pleasure?
Pleasure from all of these rubber shoots.
You have 30 minutes.
Your time starts now.
So, first thoughts, just a massive slide.
Slide.
I wish they were bigger. Because I'd just make a slide.
Well, I would just go inside.
And then what would you do?
Have a sleep.
Are they percussive?
I'm going to need 5 little chocolates, 5 little truckies.
Oh!
Are you having pleasure?
I can see a little green fly.
Yeah, right, OK.
Fern, is it fair to say that a lot of our tasks are getting in the way of you having a nice sleep?
No, it's for a very good reason. I was so excited about coming in to do the task days that I didn't sleep, which then meant I was tired and couldn't do my tasks very well. Every day when you came in, I would say I'd been too excited again.
Yeah.
Well, I've written down what my perception of what we're about to see is. I think we're getting 3 slides, one with jockeys and a big Irishman playing a giant glockenspiel.
OK, we're going to start with 2 very physical men, Munya and Dara. What are you doing with that, Munya?
I am giving myself maximum pleasure. There you go.
It suits him.
You've got to give it to the man sometimes. Give him one of these. Go on.
I don't want to.
You know those machines in baseball that whack the thing at you? You're kind of like a human version of that. And this is hurling, which is the Irish national sport.
OK.
Yes, we've set up a target, but that's not important. Let's not dwell on that.
Let's put this on. OK, good. Is that for us?
No, not at all.
Allow me to introduce you to knockout. The goal is to hit the cow.
Here we come. OK.
No.
Nope. Right, ready? Three. Did it work?
No, because you started twerking.
Right, three, two, one.
Oh, no.
Ready?
Yep.
Let's go closer.
Are we still having fun?
Yes, yes.
Yes, good, good.
You ready?
Yes.
OK, that worked!
Yes, you hit one.
Yes! That was fun!
Three, two. I'm going to go and get some water. Do you want anything?
Yeah, a little bit of milk.
A little bit of milk. All right.
Thank you.
Well, she can talk you that.
When I was a young man, my dad took me to a tennis court once for a tennis lesson. And what he actually did was fire aces past me. Watching you dredged up those memories for me, because you looked like you were just lost in your own world.
Am I your dad in this, or
you're
am
my
I
dad.
You swinging wildly? Okay.
As you're my dad, Dara.
Okay. Right. This is an interesting dynamic.
Munya, what's this giving it to the man action?
It's a sign of respect. I can do it now if you want.
Yeah, I want you to give it to the man.
All right, should I give it to the man?
Yeah,
give all right. Okay, I'll just give you one little one. Don't zoom in just because it's quite cold.
Oh. Quite gentle. who's next?
Well, I can imagine John's friends and family would like to see what John did, so here's what John did. Have pleasure.
Oh, I'm going to have a lot of pleasure.
Here we go.
Oh.
Pleasurable.
Oh, yeah. Where's the jockeys, huh?
You'll find them.
Have a little. Ah! Woo, yeah! Oh. Oh. Ah! Oh. Ah! Alec?
Yes, John?
Can I have some pleasure time now?
All right, do you want me to lower the flap?
Yes, please.
Have pleasure.
That was fantastic! Could you lift my flap?
Yes, I'd love to. Here we go.
Right. Fuck me, imagine I get this. Genuine pleasure.
Oh. Shit!
But it's fun, this is the thing, it's very pleasurable.
Okay.
Oh. Right, throw the ball, head it straight in.
You've got to leap like a salmon.
Yeah, well, I will, yeah. I'm trying my best.
Oh, fuck it.
Didn't even hit the bell.
John, what's your definition of pleasure?
Doing something well.
If I put it to you, you were demonstrably in pain throughout most of it.
Yeah, I did enjoy going down the slide, but there were five little chockies.
And then, on national television, you revealed that you're not very good at football. There was no Munya style. Yeah! There's none of that.
No, man. I'm not like Munya. You can't have given it.
You need to give it to the man, bro. I've been telling you.
I don't
Go on, give it to the man.
I enjoy
giving it to the man.
You can give it to the man.
Give it to the man. Just give it to the man. You'll feel so much better. John, give it to the man.
I don't give it to any.
Okay, three, two, one, give it to the man. And there we go.
Join us back here very soon. Very soon. I'm starting the clock now. Go! To Taskmaster. There's a little guy sitting next to me who just can't wait to talk to you.
Ooh. Before the break, Munya and Dara tried to get the most pleasure out of some rubbish shoots by using them for sport like proper men. We also saw John's attempt. Finally... Finally, it's Fern and Sarah and their ideas of pleasure.
I have an idea! It feels like I'm doing bad things to my dad or something.
I would like you to first put on a blindfold and then I'm passing you a shower cap.
Why?
To protect your lovely hair.
Oh.
Do you like bananas?
Yes.
Catch them in your mouth.
Right.
So I just want you to be ready for anything. Is that all right?
Yes. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Where is it going to come from? Yes!
I haven't finished the first bit.
Oh, well, I didn't want to give you a chance to finish it because that's not the task. The task is my pleasure.
Yeah. Are you finding it pleasurable?
Yeah, it's really good fun.
Is it?
Has that one finished?
That one's finished.
Now what? Oh! That.
Make your thin lips stick out more.
Please.
Did you say please? I won't have any passive aggressive stuff from you. Please.
I kind of wipe my hands, but everywhere I wipe it, they're getting dirtier. Oh, yeah.
That's not sore. Raise your eyebrows.
Did you say that's not sore? Oh, I can smell something. Egg?
Drink this.
Oh, it's warm. I quite like it. Is it soup?
You look scary now.
Right. Have you finished?
Yeah. I've got bananas all over my feet.
Right.
Did you enjoy yourself?
No, I didn't enjoy myself.
I did, though.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, I mean, straight off the bat, two things gave me a great deal of pleasure. Alex Horne in your dress and the sentence, catch them in your mouth.
It was so much fun because I was brought up to being, like, tidy and polite and all of the rubbish things, and it was so great to just let loose and I had a tremendous time.
I could see. You know, how many of us haven't been told by our parents, don't you throw cream at someone through a big pipe? Fern, yours was a bit more medieval, I thought. What was a curveball for me, and when it started becoming like Misery, the film, was when, out of nowhere, he decided to fill his mouth full of ketchup.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing is, he's extremely passive-aggressive, so he does a lot of things like goes, under his breath. Very English brand of passive-aggressive that just makes me want to be violent to him.
Yeah. It's so hard to score that because everybody looked like they were having fun.
Well, I have isolated their pleasure on their faces. You can see four of them here.
Oh.
A lot of genuine pleasure. John looked like this. So it's neck and neck.
I think what I need to reward is multiple forms of pleasure.
Right.
So that means Dara, even though he was pumped up like the most competitive dad...
Competitive dad.
What was that, the competitive dad?
Competitive dad. Even though Dara was such a competitive dad... He was only enjoying one form of pleasure, albeit aggressive and full-throated.
OK.
I'm going to give him 2 points.
Two to Dara, fine.
What? Yes.
I'm going to give John 3 points. Because, honestly, I think that John just expresses pleasure in a different way. That's it. I felt that Munya and Sarah were having equal amounts of fun. I'm going to give them 4 points each. OK, but Fern's well was just so weird. And the reason she's got 5 points is she didn't even say goodbye at the end. She just wandered off. OK. So, 5 points to Fern. There it
there
is.
There you go. 5 points to Fern Brady.
It's not that fast.
Well, we have two people in joint last, but two people in joint first as well, and that's Fern and John.
Next, please.
OK, well, it's time for another routine team task.
Hello, Alex.
Yeah!
This is a nice ambiance.
Oh, amazing.
You may now open the task.
Woo! Let's do it.
The best routine to
perform the best routine to this musical backing.
You've got 30 minutes. Your time starts now.
Yeah. We just did it. That's what I've got. That's it.
Let's listen to it again.
Okay.
I know 7 types of martial arts.
Did you?
Try and hit me.
No,
just try.
You told me, so you're ready. I'll hit you later on when you're making a cup of tea.
All right.
I'm not an idiot.
How do you draw a dance number?
Oh, that's a classic problem for choreographers for generations.
So we're going to do a workout routine.
Yeah. Apologies for any accidental fart.
There is this idea, of course.
I just said to John, we did that shit drawing, and he was like, that was you.
you probably had a sleep shortly after. Lots to look forward to in yours, I think.
Mm.
I think we've got a picture of Munya's face when you threatened to accidentally fart.
Yep. This.
There
he is. It's better to apologise first for anything that might happen.
Shall we crack on?
We'll crack on. With a combined age of 119 at the time of recording, it's Dara and Fern and John.
Weird.
It's the title sequence to an American sitcom from the 80s. That's what we thought the music sounded like.
And your character, Biff Chippington.
Yes. He's the actor who plays the character.
Oh, sorry.
Chip Biffington is the character. And he's also actually quite a senior doctor.
Dr. Coco Pops.
Or a recurring patient. It's difficult to know.
I'm in every week with a different problem.
Yeah.
So, like, there, my skull had to be removed from my stomach.
Sorry, had Dr. Pops died on this occasion?
I die every week.
Time for a break now, or as my uncle, who couldn't pronounce vowels, used to say, "Tum for Breckner." See you in a bit. Welcome back to Taskmaster, where we're midway through a team task.
Mmm, he's just dreamy. And right, too. There's a catchy tune which the teams are trying to perform the best routine to. We've had hospital melodrama. Now it's time to see some Sarah Munya drama.
classic training montage. Mm-hmm. You were swiping things away. Mm-hmm. There was the one finger press-ups.
Yeah.
There was the aimlessly punching at a loaf.
A big amount of meat, you know, like a carcass.
Oh, you're going for that rocky time. Vibe.
Yeah.
So we thought we'd do a more sort of, you know...
With a baguette.
Kind of, yeah, little...
You do martial arts, right?
Seven different kinds.
I'd say there are three tops.
There are only three, but he does seven.
Oh.
Right, how are you going to score them, then?
I'm going to be really generous today. I'm going to give them 4 points, because I enjoyed it very much. I'm going to give these lunatics 5 points.
Well, there we go.
Where are we for the next one, Alex?
We are in baggage reclaim, Greg.
Alex, what are you doing down there, you spicy turnip?
Hello.
Hello, Sarah.
Well, it's genuinely eerie, this.
Really messed up opening that. Oops.
Place one luggage trolley a certain distance away from the line.
Then, starting behind the line, strike that luggage trolley with another luggage trolley.
I can do that easy. Piss easy.
If you strike the first luggage trolley with another luggage trolley,
you may move the first luggage trolley further away.
You may not move any unsuccessful luggage trolleys.
Furthest luggage trolley struck wins. You have 10 minutes. Your time starts now.
Oh, they really do their own thing on the wheels, don't they? Oh, my God. Maybe years of shopping in Asda will help.
To me, this is a childhood dream, to be in an abandoned airport.
I still got searched.
Right, it's a classic game of luggage trolley bowls.
Mm-hmm. We're going to start with Sarah and Fern.
Oh, this is quite hard.
But fun. Ah, 1 meter. Yeah, I think that hit.
So I can move it back here?
Wherever you want.
OK, the further they are, the more chance there is that they veer off.
Yes.
Oh, no!
That was close.
I'm wondering whether to jam it in. I don't know what I'm doing, Alex, but I'm going to give it a go.
Yes.
OK.
I'm doing... It's touching it.
Yes!
Double trolley.
Oh, there's two! Listen, have some fun, Sarah. You look like you need more fun in your life. That's what you said. It was hurtful at the time, but I've taken it on board and I'm having a lovely time.
I actually thought I was going to do something magical there and yous would all be like... Ugh.
Come on.
Yes. 1 minute left.
Oh, Alex, I just realised I'm, like, wasting energy going up to the line when I could just be pushing from here, right?
So you're learning?
Fuck off.
Right. This is your final trolley.
No! It's like a trolley graveyard over there. It's horrible.
Maybe? Yay! Bye!
Bye-bye.
Sarah, did you surprise yourself with your temperament?
I had a nice time, and I hate when anything reminds me that exercise is all right. It really annoys me, because I think, oh, it's just shit.
Yeah.
And then I'll do some, and I'll be like, oh, I feel a bit better, and I think...
If I was giving bonus points out anymore, which I don't do, you'd be getting one for telling Alex to fuck off so poetically.
Because he did his passive-aggressive thing again.
What did he do?
He went, you see, you're learning, aren't you?
Yeah.
Patronising.
I think that one I was trying to be just nice.
Trying to be, but you've come across as that you hate women. Again. Let's crack on.
OK, next up, it's J.K. Rowling. That's John Kearns rolling some trolleys. Again, I'm so sorry. They're having fun.
Yeah. Take a run up.
You're good at this, John.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
That is impossible, isn't it?
You've had no unsuccessful trolleys, John. Good distance.
I don't know, this feels far away, this thing. Go on. Go on, you bastard!
Yeah. That's it, John.
Yeah, saw that.
Thank you, John.
I thought you looked like a professional athlete. Like you were born to bowl luggage trolleys, is what I felt. And I'm not even being mean and sarcastic like him.
I'm worried about something.
OK, John?
You didn't show my foot and the line.
You think there's a chance you might have gone over the line and then we're going to cruelly reveal it afterwards?
You've been known to do it.
It was an amazing attempt by John. It was a pleasure to be there.
Yep.
I do have to show you... just my favourite snap of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Have a look at this.
Let's have a look at that.
Behind the line! He's fine! Well behind the line.
It's the end of part three, and if you think it's been rubbish so far, don't worry. Someone's going to win a fidget spinner after the break. Join us for the final part of Taskmaster. We haven't finished the trolley pushing task, had we, little Alex Horne?
Good Lord, no. John's in the lead so far, but there are two people left to go. One's smart, one's fit. So finally, it's Ó Briain versus Ó Briain.
Let's start off ambitious. Alex, what's the thing we've been saying this whole series?
Happy birthday.
Go big or go home. Right. All right, and that is what I plan to do.
Let's get one in the bank, as we often say in the trolley pushing game.
Yeah, you got one in the bank.
Gone!
Successful strike.
Well, you don't want to be using that one. OK, that's the one.
I need a slow clap. Mm-hmm. OK, start to speed up. You see, if you had clapped with a bit more passion, that wouldn't have happened.
From 1 meter further.
Oh, you think I was being a bit cautious there, did you?
Well, a little bit.
One. Still, though, you can see that force. Dara Ó Briain ain't pushing trolleys that far.
Oh, no, don't.
Oh,
it hit!
The gentlest of touches.
Oh, that is a beauty. Come on, little bit of bend. That's it, there we go. Come on. Push. Wait a minute. Okay, right, well, look.
Ten seconds.
Go on. Yes!
Munya, you are the most confident person we've had on this show because whatever the task is, Munya always goes, I'm going to be amazing at this. and I believe him every time. But in fact, you were quite a show pony during that, I thought.
We had a bit of hammer, we had some discus, we had some long jump, we had some double team. You know, I just wanted to give you the whole damn Olympics.
We had some double team, yeah? On the other side, we saw a man who's very serious about trolley bowling.
You don't get to the level I'm at trolley bowling without taking it seriously. You know what I mean?
I mean, on your last throw, you put a bit of curve on it.
I mean, I had to. It was a very fine line. Because every luggage haul is different. When you travel the world with these things, like whatever, you know. On the continent, they're built for speed.
What did you say, Munya, at the beginning? What's my catchphrase for the series? Go big or go home.
Oh, yeah.
But when Munya asked what's my catchphrase for the series, you said, happy birthday.
I said, happy birthday.
Straight away, no hesitation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's unusual, isn't it?
Would you like some distances?
Please, some distances, isn't it? Some sweet, sweet points.
Yes, well, I think we all saw Fern, unfortunately, in last place. 18.3 metres. 2 points go to Sarah for 25.4 metres. And then we move into the Noel Edmonds zone.
The Noel Edmonds zone?
Well, I've measured the rest in Noel Edmondses. So, Dara, 16 Noel Edmonds and one crouching Noel Edmonds. John, 19 Noel Edmonds exactly. Munya, 17.7 Noel Edmondses. John Kearns,
Kearns takes it!
Over 34 metres. Amazing.
That's sensational work. Can I see a scoreboard, please?
He's still on the lead. It's John Kearns with 18 points.
Terrible.
Unbelievable.
Hi, everyone. Please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show.
Alex, who's going to read the task out, please?
Munya is going to read the task out.
Munya!
So, one member of your team must write down 10 animals in 2 minutes.
So, who's doing the animals?
Yeah, I know loads of animals.
He's got too much confidence for me.
No,
be paired with somebody a bit meeker, please.
Team of three, who's going to be writing the animals?
I'm going to write the animals.
And team of two? That was an easy decision. Right. You can step onto the circles in front of the easels. Okay, so your 2 minutes to write 10 animals starts.
But can we watch the way Dara's arm moves and work out what he's writing?
Yes, you can.
Yeah, and if you do that, let me know because we'll go on tour and I'll make money off you.
What's he written for the first one, Fern?
I think cat.
And that's your time up. Well done. Return to your spots. Please don't talk to your teammates. The scoring on this task, just so you know, the winning team will get 5 points, the losing team, 0 points.
Whoa.
OK.
Well, the second half of the task, Munya's going to read that as well.
Communicate the other team's animals to your team members by saying the letter that comes before it in the alphabet over and over whilst doing an impression of that animal. Most correct animals named wins. You have 2 minutes and one pass.
OK, Dara's team, who is going to do the miming? Any one of you.
Oh.
Oh, I think John should do that.
I'll give it a go.
Wait, there are animals. I know all them.
Yeah. John, please make your way over to the other spot. Yeah. And John, you're miming those 10 animals. Good luck.
K.
Lemur.
K.
Lion.
Lion is correct.
orangutan.
elf. Elf.
Monkey.
Monkey is correct.
Bee. Bee.
Cat.
Correct.
Bee.
Whale.
I shouldn't give clues, but this is the shittest impression of that animal I've ever seen.
Google 1 minute, John.
Oh, pass.
Okay, is this the pass?
Shark.
Shark.
It is a shark.
G.
Horse.
Wonderful, yes.
B. B. B.
Carp.
Me.
Haunting cry of the wild wolf.
Team of two. Munya, please come to the binding step. Sarah, please go to the receiving circle. You have 2 minutes, starting...
B, B.
Cat.
Correct.
C. C.
Dog! Dog!
It is dog, it is dog.
F.
Giraffe.
Correct.
S. S. S.
Toad?
Not
tiger?
It's not a toad or a tiger.
S.
Pass.
Oh, she's used the pass.
L, 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 L,
L. You begin with M, that looks like a frog.
L. J, J.
It is kangaroo, it is kangaroo.
B, 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 B,
B, B, B, B, B, B, B,
B, B, B, B, B,
B, B,
B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B, B,
Q, 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 Q,
rabbit.
Q.
It is rabbit. 3 seconds.
A, 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 A.
And that means the team of three scored 7, while the team of two also scored 7. It's a goal!
So let's add those to the final scores and see where we are. Come and join me.
A great boy.
I'm a great boy.
What happened?
Well, they both knew exactly the same amount of animals and how to mime them. It was 7 all, so they get 5 points each. Well done, both teams. So, I can give you the series scoreboard, because we're halfway through the series.
Oh, yes, please.
From bottom to top, Munya has 75 points, John 76, Fern 79, Sarah on 90, and Dara has reached triple figures with 102.
Scoreboard for this episode.
The winner with 23 points is Mr. John Kearns.
John wins. All of those expensive, useless things are yours. Go and get them.
So,
What have we learned today? We've learned that some people are born with natural athletic ability. Dara has his hurling skills. Munya can target a cow through a rubbish chute. John can hit a trolley from 19 Noel Edmonds away. Fern can accurately throw a banana into the mouth of an idiot. And Sarah can punch a floating baguette. But if you've got children at home who are not naturally sporty, just leave them to develop and they'll find their own skills and interests. Don't be such a competitive dad! Well done again to today's winner, John Kearns!
Munya Chawawa is back unpicking the life of a real tyrant, Robert Mugabe, next Thursday. How to survive a dictator at 10. Gogglebox celebrity flavour tomorrow with the Rouseys, Tom Daley and Charlotte Church. Watching The Watcher. How suitable. Be in for 9. But next up, I hate you.